weeks. I know that the month of March is almost over, and I promised y'all a Q&A. Y'all ask questions on my community tab right here on YouTube, and I'm getting ready to answer the questions. But in the meantime, you know your girl has got to be the space. So while them questions and answers going on, how about I go ahead and do my makeup as well, and you get two for one today. Is that okay with you? Now, if you're a newbie to the channel, listen, don't be a stranger. You need to join the Beautiful Babe Brigade. And, you know, come on, be part of all of this goodness over here. We got y'all, okay? We got y'all. So, let me answer these questions. And, like the honorable mention has got to go. If y'all check out my community tab, the honorable mention has got to go to Patsy, who just went overboard with these questions. Now, some questions, I'm telling you the truth, I don't know. I'm gonna answer everything I can, you know, within reason, and let it go. Okay, we gonna do this. And I'm gonna save your questions for last, Patsy, because all the rest of them, 2,859 questions is from you. But the rest of them, let's get to it right now. And again, subscribe and hit the post notification bell. Let's get it.
For babes, so I went ahead and fixed me a little drinky drink, a little Tito's vodka and some cranberry juice. So now it's time to get this Q&A going. And y'all, needless to say, the very first question on my birthday Q&A is from Bread Girl, and she asked me, how old are you? Girl, now clearly y'all know she's probably not someone who hangs out with me a whole lot, because if you do, then you know I tell my age all the time. It's no secret. And honey, just for you and for all of the other folks who want to know, I turned 56 years old. Woo-hoo. All right, we have a question here from Busy Mom. She says, love your videos. So many tips, tricks, and knowledge. Ever think you'll come out with a beauty book? Well, you know, Busy Mom, I'm too busy. I don't think so. I think I love what I do, specifically on YouTube, sharing the tips and, you know, I just really interacting with folks. I love that. The beauty book, you know, it's a possibility that I could do like a little recipe book or something like that, but that's about it. That's all I can see. Okay, next we have Raquel Bremage. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing your name correctly, Raquel, but I'm going to try it. And she says here, let me get to the full question. Happy early birthday. Of course, y'all know I'm a month behind or so on this. Q&A would be fun. Some thought-provoking questions like, what was your hardest life lesson and how did you overcome? Okay, and her other question is, what is your happiest memory? And number three, what's next in the next chapter for you? And funniest memory. Man, y'all laying it on the line, honey. So I'll go ahead and take what I can take out of this. I know this video may be a little bit long, so instead of speeding up my makeup tutorial, I'm probably gonna have to slow it down. So here we go. What was your hardest life lesson and how did you overcome it? I wish I had read these questions beforehand. My hardest life lesson. Okay, my hardest life lesson. I'll first start with that and I'll go into the second half of the question. My hardest life lesson, I can't say on a specific thing, but to say this, that people will tell you anything. And that's the truth. You know, at spur of the moment or just because, people will basically tell you anything. And I'm talking about a person that you may just really can't trust, okay? And the way I overcame that was too many times burned, too many times lied to, too many times something that was said that's gonna happen didn't happen. So now I take everything with a grain of salt. Simple as that. That's all you can do. You know, my husband always say, you know, you can't count your chicks until they hatch. You know, you just can't do it. So that is the lesson that I've learned. And it took a minute because, you know, you get excited about promises made and things don't come through. So people will tell you anything for sure, just for that moment. And that's about all it is. And the next thing is, what is your happiest memory? Oh, I have so many happy memories. Oh my gosh. I have so many from childhood till now. But just to name a few, you know, childbirth, having my babies, getting married. Of course, this, if y'all don't know, my fourth marriage, and it is the golden marriage for sure. My first single released when I started in the music business. You know, it's just so many memories. Starting my YouTube channel and getting the very first subscriber. I have so many memories. And at this moment in my life, you know, having my family, a husband, you know, just everything coming together and starting my business here on YouTube and my music business, those things just, that's my world, that's my joy. So, and her next question is, what's next in this next chapter for you? For me, as y'all know, I have a lot of different things going on. Number one, where I got started actually in the entertainment business is singing, playing my saxophone. I'm looking forward to a new release coming, hopefully when all this other stuff gets out the way. Pretty much right now, everything is on hold, and that's on hold for right now. And my other thing is, I love the direction that my YouTube channels are going in. I thank God for you all. I thank God for the opportunities that brands are reaching out to me, that I do get sponsorships, that things are really growing, and I'm just so thankful. I'm just eternally thankful for everyone and every piece of this puzzle that's come together. Yes, it's a lot of work, but I'm here for it. So I am ready to take those steps. And my funniest memory, I'm trying to think of what is my funniest memory that I can think of right now. Oh, just so many things. Oh my gosh. You know, really every day is a joy. And I tell you one thing, if y'all know my husband, he's such a character. And every day he gives me something to laugh about, to smile about all the time. And I love his lighthearted spirit with a lot of things. When moments I get tense, that's when he loosens up the most and lets me know, listen, it is what it is, roll with it. And that's what I love. So funniest memory, I got so many of those that we can't even go into it, because you know I'm 56 years old. So let me move on. And thanks to my first couple of questions here from Bread Girl Busy Mom Raquel. Now let's move on to the Ginger Glow. Hey Ginger Glow, she asks, well, she didn't really ask a question, she just said happy birthday in advance, fellow Piscean. Thank you so much, Ginger Glow. All right, next up we have Lola Love. Lola Love says, so pretty. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And Beautiful You says, you share the same birthday as my mom. Well, happy birthday to your mom. Happy birthday to me and everybody that was born this month, and Pisceans, all of that and all of that. Okay. So, Jackie Hazel. Hey, Jackie. Jackie's always hanging out with me. I love it so much. Jackie asks two questions. How tall are you? And would you consider doing family vlogs? Okay, how tall am I? You know, there's really some controversy in that. I don't really know. Oh, it's been so long. I know they take my height when I go to the doctor, but oh my goodness, I am somewhere in between 5'3 and 5'4, somewhere in there, okay? So not really tall, you know, not tall at all, okay? So, and would you consider doing family vlogs. Family vlogs, you really got to have a family that wants to do vlogs with you, okay? Now, Mike and I really run kind of different shifts because, y'all, our schedules are like this. He has been accustomed to always kind of going to bed early. I stay up late and he gets up early and I sleep late. He's usually doing one thing, I'm doing something else. Maddie and I usually hang out together a lot, you know, heading different places, yada, yada, yada. But you know, with kids and these vlogs, when they get to a certain age, they really just don't want to be intruded upon and don't want the camera in their face. So for the most part, it's just Mike and I trying to hold the fort down when it comes to the videos. If we're going to do any kind of vlogs together, he don't mind being on camera. I don't mind being on camera, but Maddie does not. So she's the only other person that could be involved in this. But every now and then you'll get us all together. So considering a family vlog, it's not probably gonna happen. You know, we'll be doing little things here and there, but I thought about it, I tried, it don't work for us. So it's just me, I'm sorry. I hope I'm enough. And now we get to Patsy Clark. Patsy, girl, you just went all in. She sent in 17 questions, and let's see if we can knock these out. I'm already over 10 minutes into this thing. But anywho, Patsy, look, you just wait. I'm going to have some questions for you one day. She says, hello, sweet angel. I didn't really know what types of questions you wanted us to post here for your Q&A on your outstanding birthday, but here are a few that I thought of. Hopefully I didn't go overboard on this. Yes, you did. Yes, you did, Patsy. You went overboard. Let's see what we can do. And, you know, we're going to try it. Question number one, describe your perfect mascara. Have you found one that fits your specifications? Let's do it like this. Describe my perfect mascara. My perfect mascara is always waterproof. If you know me and you watch any of my makeup looks or tutorials, you know I wear waterproof. And the one that I use all of the time is Maybelline, and it is, can't even think of it right now, Voluminous, etc., etc. I'll have it linked below, or I'll put it right here on the screen, which you'll probably see it in this makeup tutorial. That's my favorite one. And number two, what kind of coverage do you prefer from a foundation? Listen, I don't like to look cakey. I think overall, I don't really have a lot of you know, imperfections to cover up. So I really like for my foundation to lay as smoothly and as skin-like as possible. So that's me. I don't want heavy coverage. I don't have to double down on it and triple down on some foundation. So I'm good with, you know, a light coverage, light to medium coverage. Number three, what is your favorite high-end brand of cosmetics? You know, I have a lot of makeup, y'all know I do, but I have a lot of makeup only because I don't per se have a favorite. If I had a favorite, I probably wouldn't have as much makeup. I use all that makeup. You know, I go from the lowest to lowest, cheapest of cheap to higher end products, but I don't really spend a lot of money on high end products. If I had to say, and this may or may not be high end, I would say I lean more towards a Tarte and a MAC product. Okay, MAC Cosmetics and Tarte. That's it. Okay, question number four. What cosmetic brands have you always wanted to try but still haven't? Okay, I can answer that one. I would think it would be, I know it is, Fenty Beauty, Rihanna's line. Fenty Beauty is probably one I would love to have more products from, indulge more heavily in, and I have not yet. Number five, do you like crocheted items such as throws or afghans? You know, I actually do. Actually, in my living room where I'm sitting right now, but you think I'm in the beauty room because I'm doing my makeup. But right now, you know, I always have a throw or something because, you know, how the house gets kind of chilly. And I love throws and I love, you know, afghans and stuff like that. I do. So number six, in case you want to, you know, crochet me up, throw or something, just kind of look at cream, or maybe like a little bit what they call that color, blush, cream or blush, something like that. That'd be perfect. I'm just kidding. Okay, next up, number 6. What is your favorite drugstore brand when it comes to makeup, eyelashes, lotions, etc.? Let's say for makeup, I probably have a lot of, probably like Wet n Wild. I have a lot of maybe Maybelline products that I use a lot, and probably NYX, I would say. For eyelashes, I would say Ardell is my favorite. And as far as lotions, I really don't do any drugstore lotions. Really, the only lotions I use, the lotion I prefer and always use is from Avon, and that's Moisture Therapy, the unscented Moisture Therapy. That's it. Number 7, is there any kind of makeup you can't leave the house without? If I leave the house and I don't have nothing else on, I gotta have some lip gloss, something on the lips, because I can always throw some shades, but that's about it, if I just have to run out like that. But most of the time when I get out, it's always planned, so I'm always gonna try to look cute. But every now and then, your girl have to like go on out and be her natural self, and I've got to have something on the lips always. Number 8, what is your most cherished beauty product? My most cherished beauty product. Oh my goodness, do I have one of those? I don't even know. I can only say probably one thing that I know, or maybe two things I know that I could not go without if I had to just use certain pieces of makeup, and that's my waterproof mascara by Maybelline. And if I have one foundation that I have to stick with, I will stick with my Black Opal foundation stick in Heavenly Honey. That's it. That's, you know, I gotta have those two. So, number 9, how often do you shop for makeup? I don't really shop for it anymore. I just recently ordered Kat Von D's, the tattoo eyeliner. I've been wanting to try that. I've always needed a waterproof eyeliner that worked, and I'm hoping that one will, and I'll let y'all know. And her other half of that question, do you like to pick up an item here and there and get lots of goodies at once? Okay, do I like to pick up items here and there or get lots of items at once? Girl, now you know I like a whole lot if I can get it. If I can get it, that's what I want. Okay, I want that, I want that, I want that, I want it all. But yeah, that's me for sure. Okay, number 10, do you have a beauty budget or you spend freely? I have not a good budget, no budget, don't have a budget. So when I spend like, okay, I'm off and take some money here and I'm going to do this for myself, okay? So I imagine it's just spend freely, because I really don't set aside a certain amount for, you know, beauty products, etc. But my entire life and work is made up of certain, you know, of products constantly. And again, I thank God for the opportunity to have sponsors that do send some of the products that I use for my beauty treatments, which is awesome. But as far as makeup, I don't really get a lot of free stuff on that. So when I budget for something, it's just going to be, or well, I can't say budget for something. If I spend money on makeup or beauty products for myself personally, it's just spending, girl. It's just spending. It's click submit. Gotta get it. Number 11. If you could only buy one brand, which brand would you choose? Well, if I could only buy one brand, I would have to probably go with Black Opal, because that's where my foundation is. That's the, you know, because I gotta have that foundation if nothing else, okay? I want that foundation. And I know they got a waterproof mascara, so I may be all right. Okay, I can do that. Black Opal. All right. Number 12, what company or companies have you been most successful with when it comes to collaborations or partnership with a product? Wow, there's been a number of them, and it's just some people that just give you that warm and fuzzy feeling that you enjoy with them, you know, you just enjoy working with them so much, and they work with you, they you know, you deliver and they deliver what they promise. I will say truly Immortal Opulence. I love working with them. SVA Organics, absolutely amazing. I use a lot of oils, and the partnership there is so awesome, and I appreciate them so much. It's so many that I can really think about. Y'all know I love me some Simply Earth, and I love what they do as far as giveaways to my folks. I love that. I mean, there's a number of them that I could really probably name off, but I will just stop there. But, you know, the folks that I work with, the products that they have, I love. I couldn't promote it if I didn't love it. And, you know, what I share, I truly have a liking for or a love for. So that's all I got to say on that. But, you know, when you talk about collaborations and partnerships, you know, when you receive a product, if it's not something you can't really find yourself using and picking up again and again, then it's something that you really should not be promoting. And that's me, you know. But what I have, when y'all see me, you know, I'm constantly using the products or things that I have had a working relationship with the company and with the product. It works for me and I love it. So thumbs up for that. Number 13, do you think there are some essential oils that are toxic to humans? When I say toxic, I mean that could cause seizures, hallucinations, or a person becoming agitated. Now, I personally don't know of any essential oils off the top of my head that would cause any issues like that. And the one thing I got to say, you know, I know there are some for certain people that should not be using certain essential oils. And that's a great topic you brought up. That's one that we need to definitely delve into in a future video. And I like that question. That's very intense and very, very, you know, something that should be on the table that we need to talk about, because essential oils are so interesting to me and I love them so much. But again, everybody cannot use them. Okay, so we're going to get into that, and I want everybody to kind of look into my community tab. I did share with y'all an essential oil booklet, and I want everybody to download that, because it'll give you some great information. But I take one essential oil at a time to kind of study about it, find out about it, make sure that it works for me, because I do have animals in the house, my guinea pigs, my dogs come in every now and then. So you have to be very cautious about that. So good question. But we're going to jump into that some more. Thanks, Patsy, for that. Number 14. So when we use the essential oils on our skin for a certain problem we are having, how does it reach the parts of our bodies that are causing us pain, for instance, or other elements? This girl getting too deep. Now, Patsy, you know I wanted these questions to be fun. Can I not answer that at another time? That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to answer. I wanted some fun, exciting questions. You know, y'all got so serious on me. So that one, we're going to leave that. We're going to talk about essential oils. Perhaps we just need to talk about essential oils, because she got a whole lot of essential oil questions coming up in this thing. And girl, I'm not about that today, especially after my Tito's and cranberry juice. Mm-hmm. Anywho, beautiful babes, listen, I'm going to stop there with the questions. Really, the rest of Patsy's questions is about essential oils, so I know she wants to talk about some more things. And what I'm going to do is answer your questions in full in a separate video about essential oils, because I really wanted this to be fun. Y'all serious with me? Goodness gracious. Oh my goodness. Maddie, you got a question for me? Maddie don't have any questions for me. So basically, y'all, I guess that gonna be that. because that's all I have. Aunt Patsy winded it up. She said, well, I hope this helps you out when you do your video. This is going to be exciting. Look, girl, I want it to be exciting. Patsy, you too serious. You too, girl, you better come on now. It's a Friday night too. Getting different viewpoints, everyone that decides to join in the conversations. I would have loved more people to throw some questions at me, but I guess this is it for now. And if you want more Q&As, y'all come with me with some real intense, interesting, juicy questions, okay? Y'all come on with it. I ain't scared. Y'all must be scared. Y'all better stop. Y'all know what time it is. Beautiful babes, I am finito, okay? I'm getting ready to finish off my Tito's and cranberry juice. I'm going to finish up this video and get it out to y'all. So y'all will know the next Q&A, it better be lit.
Alrighty, babes, so that is it. I hope you enjoyed the little Q&A. We're going to keep it going. Hey, we're not going to stop in March. I want some more Q&As, so I will let you know in the community tab when the next Q&A will be. So make sure you tune in for that. And thanks again for all of the question submissions. I enjoyed it myself. And I will see y'all on the next one. So make sure you like this video. If you indeed enjoyed it, give it 5,000 likes. Give it 5,000 likes. I would love that so much. And beautiful babes, y'all know what to do. Subscribe, hit the post notification bell, and please share your girl with your world. I'll see you on the next one.